In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Glory be forever.
When the Pentecost had come, they were all gathered together in one place. Of course, the Holy Church celebrated the great feast of Pentecost, the descent of the Holy Spirit upon all of the disciples and apostles and the Lord of God, and all the people who had been separated today, because yesterday something very special happened. The governor of New Jersey said, you know what? I'm going to let you have more than 10 people in your church. And as soon as I heard that, the police chief called. He said, Father Matt, I got good news. The only good news the police chief in Rockaway has ever given to me. Father Matt, I have good news. You can have more than 10 people in your church. And I said, thank God. And I said, you know what? I don't know how God feels about this. These are Father Matt's words. The rest of me is. This was Joe's first miracle. He wanted so badly for you all to be together. He made sure that he pulled some strings so that we could all be together, gathered in one place. And so it is. Thanks be to God. Joe is very much like the Holy Spirit. I know that throughout his life, he brought many, many people together. He comforted and strengthened people. He impacted people in such an astounding way that if we still hadn't had any limits on the amount of people that would be here, sure, there would be more, which is pretty good for a 91-year-old man. Because when you turn 91, there's not a whole lot of your peers that are left. But look, they're here, and they want to be here. Also, like the Holy Spirit, I know that Joe moves quickly. He met you, right? And then a few months later, you got engaged. And then just a few months after that, you got married. Joe didn't slow down for anything. When he knew what was right, he went after it. And thank your dad. Every time that something good or something pure happens in your lives, you're going to think of him. And especially every time you bite into something sweet, you're going to think of him, because he's always cheating. Nobody told him. I know that he also offered compassion and strength to the many people he impacted, most of which we will never know about, when he was working in New York City, helping so many who were in need, desperate, in need of attention and care and love. That's just what he was able to provide. That's just what he was able to give. Personally, he was one of the first people that came to Rockaway, or that came to the house and met me when we were in Rockaway. He came to the door, I saw a car pull up, and I saw a gentleman get out. I didn't know who he was, what he wanted. He pulled out, and he had in his hands a big bag. He came up to the door and he knocked. I opened it. He said, Slava Jesus Christo! And I said, Slava Niki Bogu. And he said, I'm Joseph Roman. And he said, Vitaite! He gave me this big loaf of bread. I know that he very much loved the traditions of our people. I know that he very much loved the foods of our people. I know that he very much loved to go and visit there in the old country. I know that he very much loved its folk music and its traditions. But I believe that there was something that he loved altogether more than all of those things that are in this world. The thing that he loved most of all, he had a little taste of the kingdom of God already. And we know that also he comes from a kingly family, so he's getting ready for the kingdom. He knows there's a special spot for those Romanovs in the kingdom of God. waiting for his place. There. You see, Christ says to us that he has eternal life. In the Gospel of John, as we read this morning, when we received him into the church. But not those who believe have eternal life. Christ goes on further to say something else. Something altogether more important, otherwise he wouldn't have said it at all. And what is it that he said? That he who eats my flesh and my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up. It's either one way or the other. We're either all the way in, or we're all the way out. I hope and trust. But Job was all the way in. Now it's us to make sure that we're also all the way in, so that when we find ourselves in Job's position, we're ready to go. We acquired love, meekness, and gentleness, and kindness, thanksgiving, all of these beautiful things that the Holy Spirit provides in our hearts and in our souls. When my son came into my office on Monday morning,